I wanted to be able to add something valuable. And that is what I try to do when I work with co-ops, is trying to get them to look at how they can be thought leaders and be strategic in their marketing plans and in their signage and in their layout and anything that would be a visual communication to a store, how they're able to take that and really be leaders in their community. I try to teach thought leadership, and it's kind of like the buzzword lately of the marketing world, but basically it is taking yourself a successful business, but you're also a successful person and successful group at making a difference and being awesome at it and being the leaders in your community and kind of the place to go when people need something and they know that you were there to provide it. Valuable content is also kind of a buzzword that keeps going around, and people talk about it with social media, and it's incredibly difficult to know what is valuable, what a board wants to hear versus what a co-op shopper wants to hear versus what the employees want to hear. So part of being a thought leader and strategically thinking about that is kind of figuring out what would be the valuable content for the majority and what your target market and demographics are. And that's something that's really difficult for people to understand because that changes every other day. And half the points that people were talking about today is exactly what I deal with. It's, well, how do you make your employees happy? And how do you make sure that everyone's on the same page and they're all hearing the same message when everyone's background is different? And I think it was Dave who said, meet them on their journey. And that is always what I tell co-ops and always what I tell especially marketing departments, is it doesn't matter what you think personally, and it doesn't matter what is going on inside your co-op necessarily. If you can't get the people in there because you can't meet them on their journey, then you don't have a business. So you have to figure out how to engage them and how to make them see the difference between a co-op and, you know, the Costco down the street. Also have to bring in your workers, because if you don't have productive, happy employees who are happy with their benefits, they are like, they just lead co-op and wear their logo and branded stuff everywhere, then it's really hard to have those awesome ambassadors in the community. So you have to make sure that you are able to foster some innovation. And a lot of that is centers around change, which is incredibly scary. And it is daunting to talk about, and we have been talking about it for a long time, and it's especially important now with competition coming in. But bringing in the staff and letting them have those ideas and have open thought processes is something that a thought leader needs to look at and also be able to say, yes, that's a good idea, or no, it's not a good idea. But also know that it's okay to try something and have it fail. Great ideas don't come from just one person or one place or one time. It's building on a bunch of other ideas that have come up, and maybe they've worked and maybe they haven't, but building on that is really what is the key to that success. Branding's huge, we all know that. Being like the token millennial right now, we do shop differently. We do live differently than a lot of other generations, and it's incredibly difficult to get a millennial in there. And it's gonna be visual, it's gonna be what's convenient. We shop at 6 different locations instead of just one. If you don't have it at a good competitive price, yes, we will go on Amazon and buy it. I tried not to particularly, but you know what, you have young kids, you've got a career, you have 14 million things that you have to do, and if your co-op doesn't have it, and it only has this product because of their standards, or they have this product because it's organic. Well, I may not buy conventional, but I will go buy something from Target every now and then. And it's not cool. It doesn't support what we strive so hard to work for, but it supports the shopper and lets them come in and then be a part of the community. And then they want to engage and they're able to participate. And then you have that democratic process. If you don't get them in there, you don't have that, and then you're gone. So if you have to lower things a little bit, that's okay. If you have to bring in some conventional products, that's okay too. It's all open. It's not like you're hiding the fact that it's, you know, strawberries not organic. We're transparent, but we also want to make sure that you are meeting the needs of your community. And content marketing is huge in that. If you have social media, or if you have a website, and I'm sure everybody does, Twitter, Instagram, whatever it is, you have to make sure that you're able to give them something that nobody else is. So just reposting or putting videos on there isn't always going to work, because they can get that on 50 other sites. It's not going to make it in their newsfeed, and it's not going to stick in their brain. So So you have to figure out who your target market is, who your demographics are, and make sure that you're able to give them something valuable to work with and something that they can take and then look at somewhere else and say, that is from my co-op. That is exactly what I needed at that time, and that is why I shopped there. Some of the qualities, I mean, we've talked about most of them. Some of the biggest stuff that I think about is being able to be a planner and look at the entire picture. When I go in and work with stores on, say, a store planning project and it's a reset, I meet with all of the department heads, I meet with the store manager, general manager. If it's a startup, say, and they're getting a new project, I will work with the board. But everyone is very focused on their own department, and it's incredibly hard to look at the big picture. And as thought leaders, that is our job. We have to take everybody's input and everybody's ideas and be able to put that on the table and then be able to build a plan around it. It can't just be focused on one area, whether it's your marketing department or if it is your produce department or whatever that is. It's not just one solution. It's a big mess, hodgepodge of all different kinds of solutions. And I think that a lot of people do have those qualities, and we're not getting enough general managers and we're not getting enough team leaders. But if we are able to then foster that and look at some of the different qualities that may be on here that you might not think someone has, bringing them on board or bringing them up through the co-op is another way to kind of look at that leadership role, because it doesn't have to necessarily be someone in a general manager. You can also have really awesome thought leaders in your departments.